Drum roll, please. Alright, so we're going on a hair fixing journey with me. Okay, so first you want to wash your hair. I use John Masters Organics Lavender and Rosemary Shampoo. So after you get out the shower, hair's all wet, put your towel on to dry it. Some people don't use towels because they leave lint in your hair. I don't use a lot of stuff that makes the lint stay, so it always comes right out. So, yep, pat it dry. Yeah. So, take off your towel. Hair is still damp, but it's not dripping wet. Then, what you want to do is get out your oil. That's Be Mine Mango Serum. And it's good for your hair. Yeah, promise. Now, I put it first in the scalp. It has a nice nozzle on the end, so it's easy application. So you can just go through in between your parts and put the oil in to treat your scalp. That'll help prevent you from getting dandruff. It also helps strengthen your roots, and the essential oils in the hot oil treatment will help promote healthy hair growth as well as just a healthy scalp. So the first thing you want to do is take the oil and rub it over the entirety of your hair. You want to massage it in good to the scalp, and personally I like to add a little extra moisture for when I add the stocking cap or shower cap, whatever. Cover your whole head. It's pretty simple. And then once you get all your hair tucked in, you want to get out the blow dryer. Now, the blow dryer causes steam to be created inside of your plastic cap, so it does the same job as one of those cool, expensive steaming machines. Then I put a towel over my head to hold in the heat for about 15 minutes. Then I remove the towel and the shower cap, and then proceed to the shower to rinse it out of my hair.
That's awesome.
So once you're done rinsing your hair, you want to towel dry it slightly, so that they're just to get rid of the excess water. You know, just pat it, nothing extensive, and take it off. What's next? Then you want to get whatever your product you use to twist your hair. I use shea butter to twist my hair, well, this particular shea butter concoction. It comes in a mason jar. It's interestingly sealed. First you screw off the outer cap, and then you pop off the tin lid. As you can see, haven't really used it much, but it's very soft. It melts instantly with the touch. You don't have to do anything extra to make it melt. It melts when you touch it. It's very soft, very oily, really, but light. Oh, here's the clips. You need your clips. I have single prong clips. double prong clips and safety pin, the bobby pins and the duck bill clips. Okay, so the first thing I like to do is mist my roots with water before I begin twisting. I get out my twisting product and just use really a little bit. You don't need a whole lot. It's not greasy, but it is made with oils, so it actually does a pretty good job of holding my hair and while also moisturizing and nourishing. I'm not gonna explain right now how to twist because there's a million videos on that, but it's pretty simple. So here's the back of my head after doing the first row. You can see I use the double prong clips mostly, especially because they're smaller and stay pretty easily. I use the duck bill clips to hold my hair out of the way, and I use the smaller, the single prong clips on hair that is harder to hold, that doesn't stay twisted as easily, and it holds on to it better. So it's just a tighter clip than the double prong. So I tend to use those towards the front and on hair that isn't as curly. Then yeah, more progression. Just twisting away. I go row by row. Da-da-da. Fun times. One thing that may not be immediately noticeable about my hair is that I actually partially interlock my hair. I don't twist all of it. So in the upper back of my head, the top of the crown of my head, I usually interlock the larger locks there. There are also a million videos on interlocking. You just put your finger through. Well, I do it with finger. You can also use a tool, but I use my finger. Put my finger through and pull the lock through the hole created by my finger, and you do that in various directions until it is locked tightly to the root. Not too tight, but however tight you want it to be. Yeah. Mr. Roboto, things, yeah. Bop. And closer, closer, more twisting, more interlocking, pushing, pinning my hair out the way. I guess just because I can't resist, here's a quick how to twist your hair. Yeah, that's loose hair. I can stick my hand through it, finger through it. So you get your twisting solution, whatever it is that you use. Use a little bit, put it on the new growth, which is what we call hair that isn't locked, not necessarily hair that is brand newly grown or something since the last time you twisted it. It just isn't locked for one reason or another yet. And then you twist. Personally, I just twist at the root. I don't really palm roll my locks. I just twist the root where the new growth is and put a clip as close to the base as possible and just let it go. And that's it. And do that all over the head until you're finished. Do, 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 do. Yay! Whole head of twisted and interlocked locks. Huzzah! Because that took more than long enough. Then the final step, blow dry. You can also let it air dry. I like to blow dry at first on the highest setting and then on the lower setting, and I'll just leave it. It doesn't matter. Just as long as it's done. As long as it's dry before you take out the clips. You could also blow dry a little bit after you take the clips out if you're worried about it holding. And then the final result.
This is a song. Every girl who's ever been through something she thought she couldn't make it through, yeah. I sing these words because I was that girl too, wanting something better than this, but do I turn to?